Welcome back, guys. In the previous two videos, we learned about databases, MySQL, and PHPMyAdmin. In this video, we are going to learn about SQL queries. So what is an SQL query? SQL query, or rather SQL, stands for Structured Query Language. It's a programming language using which the programmers communicate with a database. See, let's take a scenario. You are building a database application using your PHP language. Now, using PHP, you are going to create a login app which will check whether the information entered by the user, that is email and password, is present in the database or not. So now you can easily imagine that the programmer is not going to come every time to phpMyAdmin and search for a particular information. So what he has to do is he has to write some sort of program which will eventually check in the database that if the user is present or not. So this is done using SQL queries. Okay, let's start. So this is our database mywbt_1, and it has currently no tables. So let's create a users table with four columns. We have done this in the previous video, so we are just repeating the task. User ID, it will be an integer, and the index would be primary and AI would be checked. The second one would be name, which will be a varchar of 255 in length. Email varchar 255. Password varchar 255. So this is the basic structure of our table. So now we can click on save. Once you are done with save, now you can see you have a table called users, which is currently having zero rows. So now in this video, rather than inserting or performing the CRUD application operations, we are going to do it using SQL queries. In the previous video, we did it using phpMyAdmin, the user interface. But in this video, we are going to perform all the four operations using SQL queries. We are not going to use the phpMyAdmin forms. So suppose now that our table is created, we want to add a few values into the table. Basically, I want to insert values into the table. So previously what we used to do was, we used to click on this insert tab and we used to fill up this form. And once we click on go, that value gets inserted into the database, the table. So now instead of doing it this way, let's write a SQL query which will do the similar operation. So to write a SQL query in phpMyAdmin, you have to click on SQL. When you click on SQL, you get this giant text area where you can type in your query. Okay, so you'll be greeted with this particular query. You have to remove that. And now to insert a particular value into a table, the query is like this: insert into tilde, remember, not comma, tilde, users, small brackets, user ID, our first column, name, our second column, email, our third column, and finally, password, our fourth column, with the values of inverted comma null, because it is already defined as auto increment, Narendra Modi would be the name, modi@gmail.com would be the email, and modi1234 would be the password. So if you can see, the query syntax is like this. You use the keyword insert into, then you provide the table name, then you provide in a small bracket the list of all the columns using a tilde, then you use the keyword values and you provide the values. Just make sure the order of these columns and these values has to be the same. Okay, so now if you are done with this, you simply have to click on go, and it says MySQL returned an empty result set, zero rows. Okay, now you go to browse and you will see that you have added one user, that is Narendra Modi. Okay, let's insert one more user. I'm sorry, you don't have to go to insert tab, you have to go to SQL. Again, you have to remove whatever is present on your screen and you have to write it again. Insert into users tilde user ID tilde name tilde email and tilde. If you're not able to find the tilde key on your keyboard, it's just before the number one key or just below the escape key in most of the keyboards. Okay, password with the values of, again you don't have to fill the user ID. Let's add the user to be rahul@gmail.com would be the email, and finally rahul1234 would be the password, quite similar to the previous time. Click on go, again it will return a zero rows. Now if you click, you'll get two users in your database. So this is how you write one insert query. Okay, now suppose I want to change the name of Narendra Modi to say LK Advani, and I want to change his password from Modi1234 to LK1234. Okay, so basically I want to perform an update operation. So again, in the previous case, what we used to do was, we used to do it from here like this, double click, edit. But suppose you are a programmer who doesn't have the access of this phpMyAdmin software. So in that case, for everything that you want to do with the database, you have to write a SQL query. So again, if you want to update certain values in the database, you can do it with SQL. So let's go back to SQL query and let's perform an update operation. To update, you write a query like this: update table name, that is users, set, the word set, the column name, that is name, is equal to whatever you want to change it to, LK Advani, comma, password LK1234, where you have to provide, obviously you want to tell the database that I want to change the name to this and the password to this, but there are a lot of rows. Okay, so you have to provide something to the query which will tell the database to do this particular update operation on this particular user. So you have to provide a reference. A reference can be anything, it can be any column. So in our case, let's provide the reference to be user ID, and that will be equal to 1. So basically I'm trying to say is, update the users table, and by updating I mean you have to set name to LK Advani and password to LK1234 only where the user ID is 1. So in other language, go to the database and change the name to LK Advani and password to LK1234 where user ID is equal to 1. Okay, so now once you're done with this statement, you have to click on go. And it says one row affected. So if I go back and browse, now you can see your first user ID is no more Narendra Modi, it's LK Advani with a password of LK1234. Okay, so this is how you update anything in your database using a SQL query. Okay, we are going to do a lot more update operations in the future videos. So this is just a basic. Okay, now let's go to the next part, that is search. Or rather read, retrieve. So suppose I want to see the list of all the users who are present in my table. So to do that, we generally used to click on browse. Okay, and we used to get the list of all the users. But what can we do if you want to see this, the same result using a SQL query? What you have to do is, you have to go to SQL and you have to write select star from tilde users. So in a way, I'm telling select star means everything from users and go. Once you click on go, it will show you everything that is present in your table. So suppose now I want to display only the names, or rather only the email and password of all the users. Okay, so now the requirement is, I'm repeating, I have to display the email and the password of all the users. So what can I do is, I can go back to SQL and remove everything and write a new query like this: select tilde email comma password from your table name, that is users. Okay, so instead of asterisks, we have written the two columns that we want. Now if we click on go, now you can see the result set contains only the email and password of all the users. What will happen, or what can we write to retrieve the email of the user ID that is 1? Okay, so I want the email of the user ID 1. So to do that, you can again go back to SQL and you can write select email from users where user ID is equal to 1. Okay, select star from users where user ID is 1. So now if I'll click on go, it returns one total query and the email is modi@gmail.com. So this is how you actually retrieve information from the database. Remember, we are going to use select or retrieve queries a lot. So you don't have to worry. Okay, we are going to cover every case. Now let's move forward to the last part, that is deletion. How would you delete a particular entry from your table? So suppose I want to delete, let's quickly browse. Currently we have these two items and I want to delete the second row, that is Rahul Gandhi. Okay, to delete, you have to again go back to SQL and you have to write the deletion query, that is delete from your table name, that is users, delete from users where you have to provide a condition, user ID is equal to 2. So now you are saying, I want this user ID of 2 to be deleted from my users table. Okay, so now if I click on go, it will ask me with a pop-up, do you really want to execute this query? I'll click on OK and it says one row deleted. And if you go back to browse, you can see one user has been deleted. So in this video, we learned about the basics of SQL queries. We inserted, retrieved, updated and deleted elements from a database using SQL queries. In the future videos, we are going to use SQL queries a lot to manipulate our database. Okay.